Maybe you've noticed some CGI work in some of my recent brick films. Or maybe you haven't. I hope you haven't, because that means I did it well. In Princess Storm and LEGO Titanic, I used mecha bricks to create some CGI scenes and scene additions that enhanced the film. I use CGI in addition to stop motion animation when I need to create something that has to be larger than I could normally create with my LEGO collection. However, one way that I hide the fact that I'm using CGI is by using LEGO parts that I could realistically have, and not create sets that are unrealistically large. But maybe you want to learn how to use CGI and add them to your brick films. Well, you're in luck, because today we're going to be discussing the basics of how to use mecha bricks alongside stop motion animation in Blender. Step 1. Build your model. There are a few ways to import a model from mecha bricks into Blender. First, you could just download a model on the mecha bricks library. Or, you could hit up the workshop of mecha bricks, which is a virtual building environment where you can build using a variety of LEGO pieces inside of your web browser. They have a lot here, so it's very good to build with. However, my preferred way is LEGO Digital Designer. It's an outdated software, but it's still very easy to use. I'm using LEGO Digital Designer version 4.3.11. Even though you can't download LEGO Digital Designer from lego.com anymore, you can still easily get it from the BioMedia project. Don't worry, it's perfectly safe, I've used it 1,000 times. So, I go to biomediaproject.com/bmp/files/lego and scroll down until I find Setup LDD PC 4.3.11, which is the newest and most advanced version of LEGO Digital Designer. Inside of LDD, I build a LEGO scene, similar to one I could create in real life. I don't use very many parts for this example, but you can use as many or as few as you'd like. Next, we're going to save the file. Once it's saved, go into your browser, open the Mecha Bricks workshop, click File, Import, select LEGO Digital Designer, and select your file. Now you will see it's imported. One thing to note is that I used a blank LEGO head in LDD because the LEGO Digital Designer decals and the ones in Mecha Bricks don't always line up. So I replaced that blank LEGO head with a LEGO decal from Mecha Bricks that I find in their library. This way, I can be sure the decal will exist in Mecha Bricks and import into Blender. Once you have finished customizing your model all you want in Mecha Bricks, go to File, Export, select Blender Add-on, and click Export. Save it to your computer wherever you want. And don't forget to save your model in Mecha Bricks itself so that you can access it later. Step 2. Set up Blender. For this, we're going to be using the newest version of Blender, Blender 3.0, which has just recently been released. You can find it on blender.org and download it for free. After you have that, you're going to need Mecha Bricks. On the Mecha Bricks shop, you can select two versions of Mecha Bricks, Blender Lite and Blender Advanced. Blender Lite is free, but it has a lot fewer features. Blender Advanced is $25 as of this recording. However, it has a lot of more photorealistic features, which I prefer to use so that it matches my brick films better. Purchase and or download that. Export the downloaded zip, and inside you'll find another zip file. Next up, go back into Blender. Go to Edit, Preferences, and click Add-ons. Select the Import Add-on button. Find where you just unzipped Mecha Bricks, and select the file. Enable the add-on, and Mecha Bricks is installed. But for this tutorial, I'm going to be downloading another add-on that I created. On github.com/rioforce, or in a link in the description, you can find Mecha Bricks Scaler for Blender. Essentially, when you import Mecha Bricks models into Blender, they're huge, they're way too large to manage. Therefore, I created a plugin that we use after we import that will scale down the model significantly so it's easy to manage under default Blender conditions. On the sidebar, click Releases, scroll down, and download the .py file. Doing the same setup as earlier, we put the add-on into Blender. Now Next up, just delete everything. We're gonna need to empty for this. Go to File, Import, and scroll all the way down to where it says Mechabricks. After I find my file, I'm going to select it. On the side, you can see there's options, logos on the studs, and bevels. I'm not gonna use bevels, but I am gonna have logos on the studs. Now your model's imported. It looks pretty good, right? Well, if you add any other object, let's say a camera, you can see that these Lego bricks are giant, especially if you're going to be adding additional models or want to have easier camera manipulation. So, I'm going to go over and use my plugin. Go to the sidebar and select World Settings. Under Mechabrick Scaler, select Empties. This will select any of the empties, which are essentially the parent of all the Mechabricks bricks in the scene. We're gonna click Scale Down, and suddenly my model gets smaller. It's a lot easier to manage now. Because I replaced the head earlier, I need to realign it in Blender. But since Blender was my final destination, I can do it here. And now it's time to set up the scene. Step 3, setting up your scene. One cool feature in Blender is called HDR, or HDRIs. On Polyheaven, you can download free HDRI files, which are essentially 360 images of different situations, which we can use for lighting in Blender. There are a lot of different situations to choose from, such as indoor lighting or outdoor lighting. I'm going to select an outdoor scene, but you can select whatever you want. First, I download the HDRI, then I go back into Blender. I go to the sidebar and click World Settings. Instead of the color, I'm going to select Environment Texture. Then I'm going to click Open, select your HDRI file, or an EXR file for me, and we're done. Now I'm going to go to Project Properties and select Cycles. I'm going to change it to my GPU render for faster rendering. This works for some GPUs, but not for others. Now I'm going to select my camera. A button for camera settings will appear in the sidebar. Here, I'm going to change my focal length to a realistic number. 55mm is the lens I have, so I'm going to use that. Next, I'm going to go down to sensor settings, and under this button, I can access different presets for sensors. I'm going to be using Canon APS-C, which is Canon's default crop sensor. To make it realistic, I'm using real camera settings, especially those that match my current camera. Now I'm going to add a background so we can mess around with different settings. This is a simple background, which we're going to replace in a minute. But for right now, I'm going to make it blue, and I'm going to hit Render Preview so that we can mess around with the settings while seeing what they're doing. Next, let's set up the depth of field. Now I'm going to add an empty. I'm going to use a different type of empty than the regular crosshairs so that it stands out more. I'm going to put it right in front of the face of the minifigure. This will be my focal point, so that I can add depth of field. I'm going to go ahead and change the name to DOF, which is depth of field, to make it easier to find later. Select the camera again, scroll down to the depth of field menu, and select your DOF empty. If I hit render preview, I can mess around with the f-stop and see how blurry or how clear I can make the background, or rather, how shallow or how deep I can make the depth of field. This is often tricky to do for the scales that we're working in Blender, so I usually just wing it until it looks good. Now in this render, I'm using just an HDR to light the scene. But in this next photo, I'm using some lights to light the scene too. You can use a variety of different ways to light your scene. For this last example, all I did was add a simple sun lamp. But does it look realistic enough? That's the question. To add realism to my scene, I'm going to go ahead and delete the background. Hit spacebar and type in import images as planes. I've taken this picture of a poster board that's pre-lit, and I'm going to use this as my background. I've done this in multiple of my CGI animations to make it blend in with the brick films more. We're going to scale it up and put it behind our scene. You may need to light the background separately, depending on what you want your scene to look like. If you're not satisfied with the results of the HDRI, you can always use your own photos. In this scene in Princess Storm, I took a photo of my set that I was using at the time, which has the different lightings and the background on it. I'm going to use this photo as my HDR image. While it's not a 360 photo, it does provide the colors and the reflections needed to make a more realistic scene. Next up, I'm going to create lamps that are similar to ones I have in real life. I don't have to use sun lamps or spot lamps in Blender. I can use regular planes and just add an emission node. This will create lamps out of these planes. I can change the location, intensity, and color temperature of these lamps all that I want to match lamps I have in real life. As you can see here, the background is lit and the foreground is lit, and there's an HDR image surrounding the entire thing. Photorealistic Lego. Mechabricks Advance has a fun feature where you can change the scratches, dents, dust, fingerprints, and more on all of your Lego bricks at the same time. If you turn these levels up to an extreme amount, you're gonna notice them and it's gonna look less realistic. But tweaking the settings to be just enough can often make your renders look pretty realistic. Of course, the way you light it and the way you use these textures are going to differ scene by scene. I find that lighting dark scenes can often be easier to hide the flaws. Matching your brick films will depend on what your brick film looks like, so this is just an example. In Princess Storm, my setup was fairly simple. A few base plates, a few trees, and a single lamp. But it did match what I had in real life, which was basically a soft room light and one main light for the moon. This is the photo I used as my HDRI, which is essentially the set where my set would have been sitting if I had done this in real life. A little tweaking, a little rendering, and boom, it matches the scene pretty well, and I don't think many people noticed it was CGI from the start. And there you have it. I hope you learned something today about Mechabricks, Blender, brick filming. If you have any more questions, please leave them in the comments below. And if you have any suggestions for tutorials in the future, also leave them in the comments. I'd love to hear what you think. Please give it a like, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you later.